Yo, what is up, guys? Puunyo here, and today I'm bringing you part 3 of Sage Orbs that you can strategically throw, this time in Valorant's split map. Part 1 and part 2 were huge bangers and also really helpful to many, so for those of you trying to learn more Sage Orbs, check them out after this video. I'll leave links for part 1 and part 2 down in the description below. With that, let's jump right into it. I'll start with the attacking side. Lots of times when you hit B site, someone's holding either the close left pocket or the back site to hold off any push. These spots are the most threatening for you as the attacker. As you'll see, these orbs will make players in both spots vulnerable. You can push, either try to kill or trade kills with your teammates, or combo abilities like the raised ultimate or the brimstone. Being able to have that type of synergy with your team will allow you guys to get easier kills. To slow the back left site, stand at this corner and use the building's darker gray corner on the left side. It should slow off the entire back left site. To slow the close pocket, stand at this same corner and use the top of this white building's left corner as a reference guide. Have your center dot aimed slightly off to the building on the left side of it, and it should be able to land. When this lands, it'll give you some room on the right to push towards the heaven direction, and you and your team won't be slowed by it. Just make sure your team smokes off heaven or at least watches it. Speaking of heaven, that's the next most immediate threat when you enter B site as soon as you cross out of garage. I found that slowing this is best used for zoning people looking from heaven. Kill potential isn't as high, since usually your team is probably attacking from the lower ground, unless you're combining with the brimstone ultimate. That's pretty much the only strong combo to catch someone at heaven. To land this orb, just tuck yourself at this box corner near the barrier, and aim up to the top right corner of the shadow wall. It's a little harder to see, but just make sure that your crosshair is aligned to the right side of the wall, and then go slightly above it. Real quickly, if you guys are finding these spots helpful so far, I'd appreciate if you guys give this video a thumbs up and maybe even subscribe if you'd like to see more Valorant content. Let's get those 400 subs, guys. Let's get it. Moving on to our next orb, these next two strats slow off top mid and can be used to punish players in that position or just to zone it while you advance with your team. The first you can use when your teammates are planning to attack B and mid. You'll want to throw this orb from T-spawn by lining up with the sidewalk. Aim up where the white light corner makes a wide triangle and aim it there just like you see in this clip. For the second strat, if your team wanted to do something like, say, 3A and 2 mid, and you wanted to push with A while still helping mid players, you can do the same slow by standing at this plant bin. Just line up your crosshair to where the walls would perpendicularly meet, and you can aim it there. Shout out to my viewer Cloud on Cloud9 for showing me this one. Really good find there, man. Really good find. Lastly, I want to show you guys a quick strat if you're ever defending A site from heaven. This one is going to be really useful if you have any information on players that are hovering around A. And if you time this properly, the slow can stop an entire push and turn enemies into easy kills trapped in the ice. You want to line up with the end of this wall and put your crosshair where the bar building and the close rail meet. This slows the entire A choke point. The second one is optional if you're trying to cut off the enemy's escape. And to do it, you can aim right at the corner of the building, way off in the distance, as you can see on the screen. You can typically throw the first one and get away with picks, but if a team is ever stacked and they do from time to time, they would all be dead. Alright you guys, that is it for this episode. I have more guides coming along the way, so please stay tuned. Remember to give it a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the content. Comment down any videos that you'd like for me to cover in the future. I got more coming soon, and with competitive now released for Valorant, it's going to be really important to have these strategies in your toolkit as Sage, just so you can help your team find picks or just even to zone off the enemy. I'll leave it at that for you guys. Until then, take care, friend. Peace.